watching a preview of what's coming to a browser in front of you in May 2007. Coming in late May 2007, the University of Montevallo will be webcasting live a firing of our Onagama kiln. You'll see something in May that you've never seen before as the Mass Communication Division produces 4 hours of live programs from the kiln to give you a better taste of what Onagama is all about. Joining us now to tell us more about the Onagama kiln is Dr. Scott Meyer. Why did you build an Onagama kiln?
A question I asked many times while I was building an Onagama kiln. I reflected recently that each one of these bricks weighs 45 pounds, which is not that big a deal, except when you do it like 8,000 times. There are a lot of reasons for that, for the building of it. One is that artists don't assemble unless there's a reason. Artists tend to be isolated from each other, and yet all the great ideas that happen when people talk to each other. So I felt, among other things, that the Onagama would be rare enough to attract people from all over the place, and hopefully their students, some of whom you see behind you now. And when they're around the kiln for 100 hours of the firing, they talk to each other, and some of them are irreverent jokes, and some of them are pretty doggone good ideas for more art. And so that was one reason. The more immediate reason is that it's such a rare surface that you get on the surface of the work, that you can't get it any other way. If we could put this in a microwave or something instead of staying here for 100 hours and feed a kiln, I would vote yes, in a sense. It takes the romance out of it, I guess, a little bit. But the surfaces are very rare. It's 3,000 years of technology. And you can call it technology. It's old technology. And so what contemporary artists bring to it is exciting to me, because they bring a take that is relevant to contemporary issues in art. We have no interest in making 16th century storage jars. I mean, they were made in the 16th century. But what we want to do is to apply some of the approaches to work that's relevant to today's art scene.
The pieces I'm making now, the one that I'm making right now, has to set up leather hard so I can add the next piece. So I usually throw the bases for them, work on more than one at once. So I've got four going here. You take a month to build something, and then you subject it to the randomness of the firing process. Onagama kiln is an ancient way to get pots hot enough to vitrify the clay, to make the clay fuse together so that use objects can be produced. But artists from our time use it because of the interesting effects that it gives on the surface. So ideally what you want is to be thinking about what the outcome might be, where you want it in the kiln way before you actually get out there to stack it. So I'm thinking now about this piece relative to where I need it in the kiln.
And why should viewers come back in May for the full live version?
Well, I mean, I think there's a lot of answers to that, too. I mean, one of them is that I think Onagama firings make great dramatic situations. You know, I mean, a lot of live TV is very popular right now. You know, we're not going to vote anybody off the island or anything like that. But there are a lot of problems to solve, and problem solving is the essence of drama. And in the course of the 9 firings that we've done, we've seen just about everything happen once. And in May, you just might see something that we never dreamed might occur. And you might see people scramble to try to solve problems we can't possibly imagine right now.
Be sure to join us in May for an hour each with more detail on the loading, the lighting of the kiln, the firing process, and the pieces themselves as they come out of the kiln live on the web.